Last night in our series Back Inside the Tennessee Aquarium, we met the artist who designed the plan for the plaza around the building.
Tonight, we meet an artist from Rossville who has worked on one particular aspect of designing the artist's overall plan. Together, they have come up with a small bridge, which will be a salute to the bottling industry and Coca-Cola's contribution to the development of Chattanooga, as we continue our countdown to the opening of the Tennessee Aquarium. This emerald cylinder of glass is a prototype of what visitors to the Tennessee Aquarium will one day be walking over. Meant to resemble the bottoms of old Coca-Cola bottles, they will be embedded in a concrete bridge and lit from underneath, giving the walkway a green glow at night. Stephen Matthews is the local craftsman, the glass blower, who must create 167 of these gems of exactly the right shade of green to take their place in the bridge.
The glass is a molten material, which is its fascination.
To make each one of these pieces, he will go back into the 2100 degree oven three times to gather increasingly larger amounts of molten glass.
What I like about glass compared to a lot of other medias is that in its hot form and it's keeping moving, you find that perfect moment that one time and you freeze it by cooling it. And that's the moment that you're looking for.
The glass is so hot, he will not know the final color of what he has made until it cools down to 600 degrees.
I started out kind of as an apprentice, and I always felt that I was being handed down something that through the history had been handed down. Yeah, the molds are made out of cherry wood, and they're constantly kept wet. When the tree was originally cut, it was specifically for these tools, so they never let the tree dry. Themselves, even though it looks like I burned them, the blocks themselves, it's the steam that shapes the glass and not the wood. It's not the burning of the wood, but the steam that shapes it.
Using recycled glass, Matthews must come up with just the right shade of green for the final version, and then produce 200 of them so he will have some backups for accidents in the installation into the concrete.
Is the breaking off of the piece. In working with glass, there are relatively few people who work in it professionally or are capable of working in it professionally. And I do feel honored that, you know, I have the opportunity. You know, I look forward to my grandchildren walking across it and going, my grandfather made that.
Each one of these little glass gems that he has to make takes about 12 to 15 minutes start to finish. That's if nothing happens in the process. He has 200 to produce, so that's about 50 hours of turning and burning there with the glass.
And this is the wrong color, right?
That's the wrong color,
so he has to go back again.
It has to be a lighter shade of green because it's supposed to look like the bottoms of Coke bottles.
Why didn't they just use Coke bottles?
Well, to begin with, Coca-Cola didn't want the liability, and I can't say that I blame them for it. So what they've created is something that's solid, and it won't break. Hollow glass probably would have broken a lot more easily.
Yeah, you can walk over it.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about it.
Right.